y'all know how to party, don't you?
I heard you had a good time. You made it though.
Hey, and why weren't you there for this? For the
because we had a nail appointment.
Yeah, here.
Hey Symone, this is Shauna. I love you.
Is this another cousin?
Love your cousin too.
Awesome, Mom. I love you. This is Grandma Mabel.
Hi, Symone. This is Jamal's girlfriend.
Okay. Nice. And I've learned to love me too. Never have I felt that I could be all that you see. It's like our hearts have intertwined into the perfect harmony. This is why I love you.
My whole life through.
And I can't sweep you off of your feet. Will your mouth still remember the taste of my love? Will your eyes still smile from your cheek? Darling, I will be loving you till we're 70. And I can't sweep you off of your feet. Will your mouth still remember the taste of my love? Will your I still smile from your cheek. Darling, I will be loving you till we're 70. And baby, my heart could stop for less hard at 23.
Found love in you, and I've learned to love me too. Never have I felt that I could be all that you see. It It's like our hearts have intertwined into the perfect harmony. This is why I love you. No other love will do. Every moment that you smile chases all the pain away. Forever and a while, and my heart is where you'll stay. This is why I love you. Ooh, this is why.
Our most gracious Heavenly Father, we thank you for all the privileges of being in the body of Christ. We have come together to watch the miracle of your love and the power of your Spirit work in the lives of these two people. We give you the praise, the honor, and the glory for the power of the Holy Spirit in our lives to bring us into a place of union with the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and the union with one another. We thank you for it. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. As I read the scriptures from Ephesians 5, I want you to both pay very close attention to the words stated here. These are God's words that the Holy Spirit will honor as we stand on them in faith. It says, "Wives, submit yourselves unto your own husbands as unto the Lord. For the husband is the head of the wife, even as Christ is the head of the church, and he is the Savior of the body. Therefore, as the church is subject unto Christ, so let the wives be to their own husbands in everything. Husbands, love your wives, even as Christ also loved the church and gave himself for it, that he might sanctify it and cleanse it with the washing of water by the word, that he might present it to himself, a glorious church, not having spot or wrinkle or any such thing. But it should be holy and without blemish. So ought men to love their wives as their own bodies. He that loveth his wife loveth himself. For no man ever yet hated his own flesh, but nourished and cherished it, even as the Lord the church. For we are members of his body, and of his flesh, and of his bones. For this cause shall a man leave his father and mother, and shall be joined unto his wife, and they shall be one flesh. This is a great mystery, but I speak concerning Christ and the church." A miracle took place when you made Jesus the head of your life. The Holy Spirit used the very power of God, his creative power, to cause your spirit to be reborn. It is the same power of God used when he raised Jesus from the dead, and he joined you to Jesus by that power. Don't ever tamper with that union. The love of God doesn't say, "I love you, but do you really love me?" The love of God says, very simply, "I love you." That's all it ever says. Don't ever tamper with that miracle. Don't ever let the sun go down on your wrath. Yes. Something holy, something beyond reproach will take place by the Spirit of God inside of your bosom, and it is a precious thing. I want to speak to the witnesses here. Jesus said, again, I say unto you, that if two of you shall agree on earth as touching anything, that they shall ask, and it shall be done of them of my Father, which is heaven. You are not just here because of tradition. You are here for a serious purpose, to bear witness of this miraculous union that will take place and to add your agreement to it before God. Don't ever tamper with that agreement. From this day forward, regardless of what comes, you are in agreement with this union. Let me say that again. From this day forward, regardless of what comes, you are in agreement with this union. Don't ever attempt in any way to cause it to be any other thing than a happy union. Woe be to any person who would tamper with it and cause it to be any other thing than prosperous in the eyes of God. This is a miraculous thing, and it is of God. These two individuals have prepared their own vows today, and because we are untraditional, we're going to let Symone go first with her vows. Yes.
This day, I proclaim my love for you amongst our family, friends, and God Himself by finally answering that one question you've asked throughout our relationship. That question is, why I love you. Looking back, I can honestly say that I loved you ever since the first day. There was something about you that sent a warm wave of energy through me the first day I saw you. However, it wasn't until 5 years later that I realized that that feeling was confirmed when we crossed paths for the second time. During that time, I was immediately filled with love, affection, and pure joy. Back then, I loved you for the potential I seen in you, but today, I love you for your growth. I love you for your bravery, your perseverance, your resilience, determination, intelligence, and so much more. Sometimes I just look at you, and I wish that you could see the view of yourself that I see, and you could see yourself through my eyes. That way you can see and really understand just how wonderful you are. I honestly believe that I'm privileged to have someone in my life to call my homie, my lover, and my friend that will walk hand in hand in life on this long journey. Because it's one thing to have a significant other, but it makes a world of a difference to have a life partner where you can work and where you can work to tag team and conquer every obstacle, whether big or small. We truly make a great team. Just two imperfect people that balance and complement each other. So on this day, I vow to love you, respect you, defend you, submit to you, and pray for you every single day. And on this day, I vow to our God Almighty to honor my husband, to respect my husband, to encourage my husband until the end of time.
Those are your vows. Make this profession of your faith. I, Symone,
according to the word of God,
submit myself to you,
to be a wife to you.
From this moment forward,
we shall be one.
Amen. Chris will now give his vows.
Symone, wifey, from the first moment I saw you, I knew. I've never in my life felt any type of energy that you gave me when I first walked into that barber shop and you were sitting there. The same feeling I have today. Be Because of you, I am now fulfilled, because now I'm a man with a purpose. A purpose-filled life to take care of you, to honor you, to cherish you with every breath that I have in my body. So today, before God, I just want to say that I love you so much, and I will continue to work as hard as I can to give you everything you need, because I'm here for you, and I love you.
These are your vows. Make this profession of your faith. I, Chris, according to the word of God,
according to the word of God,
leave my father and my mother.
I leave my father and my mother.
And I join myself to you.
And I join myself to you.
To be a husband to you.
To be a husband to you.
From this moment forward.
From this moment forward.
We shall be one.
We shall be one.
Amen.
Amen.
Can I have the rings, please? Precious thing, a token of your faith and love. This ring is made from a precious metal. It is a never-ending circle that indicates the continuing love of God, a love that never fails, a love that never presents itself haughtily or is puffed up. The love of God and the faith of God causes its power to move in your lives. Wear these rings as a continual reminder of your faith, a continual reminder of the confession of faith you've made to each other and to God. The word of God says, above all, taking the shield of faith, wherewith you shall be able to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked one. If anyone could break up this union, it would be Satan. So give him no place.
Amen.
This is forever.
Amen.
Take this ring, place it on her finger, and say, if I can see how to read this. With this ring,
I beware.
It is a token of my love for you.
My love for you.
And a token
of my faith.
That I release now.
That I release now.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus Christ's name.
Amen.
Amen.
A ring can mean two different things. It can be a never-ending sign of love, or it can be a shackle. I charge you to remember this always. This woman stands by your side, not under your feet. You have the responsibility of being the head of this union. You have a spiritual responsibility. I want you to wear this ring in remembrance that she is your helpmate. This ring shall never be a shackle of dominance, but always a reminder of faith and love. I want you to place this ring on this finger in just a moment. With these things in mind, Symone. There's no place in the Word of God that gives people the right to dominate one another. Your vows have stated that you submit to one another in the responsibilities of this life, expecting God and His power to always make the difference. So place this ring on His finger. And say to Him,
With this ring,
I beware.
I give it to you.
As a token of my faith, I believe with all my heart
that this is forever.
It represents my love
and my faith
in the name of Jesus. Amen. As a representative of Jesus Christ before Almighty God, in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, and by the power of the Holy Spirit of God, I now pronounce you one together. You are now husband and wife. Symone and Chris will partake in the sand ceremony, representing their continuing love for each other. With each grain of sand, it shall remind you of the number of times you ought to forgive each other. No one can separate sand and count how many grains it is. So that means that every day, forgiveness never runs out. Thank you. Let me tell you what you have in store for you when you keep God first in your life.
Well, come on.
It says in Deuteronomy 28, blessed shall thou be in the city, and blessed shall thou be in the field. Blessed shall be the fruit of the body, and the fruit of the ground, and the fruit of the cattle, and the increase of thy kine, and the flocks of thy sheep. Blessed shall thou be thy basket and thy store. Blessed shall thou be when thou comest in, and blessed shall thou be when they goest out. The Lord shall cause thy enemies that rise up against thee to be smitten before thy face. They shall come out against thee one way and flee before thee seven ways. The Lord shall command the blessing upon thee in the storehouse and all that thou settest thy hand unto. And he shall bless thee in the land which the Lord giveth thee. The Lord shall establish thee an holy people unto himself, as he hath sworn unto thee, if thou shalt keep the commandments of the Lord thy God and walk in his ways. And all the people of the earth shall see that thou art called by the name of the Lord, and they shall be afraid of the blasphemy.
All right. Amen.
Chris, you may now kiss your bride. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you Mr. and Mrs. Chris Lasco.
Yeah.
All right, come on.
good, man. I'm good. Good to see you, boy.
You too.
Okay. Yeah, you gonna get to spend a little time with me tomorrow?
Yeah, I'm gonna see you tomorrow.
Okay, well, good.
Miss Contessa.
I've got a bunch of rings in order, let me tell you. They're nice people. Hey, you're a makeup lady. Here, let me get a picture of you. Hold on one second. Here,
do I have to?
No, I just like you. Stand right there, if you don't mind.
Okay.
Thank you.
drop that hand, right? All right, on three. One, two, three. One, two, three. All right, switch sides. Let me get everybody, let me get one picture here of everybody, and then we'll do everything separate underneath. All right?
You want to
do? Guys, going to be on Chris' side. Ladies, you're going to be on Simone's side.
In the order that we lined up.
Yep, same order. Yeah, you're coming out. Yeah, y'all can walk underneath. I'm gonna get those group pictures over there. Yeah, I'm going to get No, you're going to, I'm going to take some over here. I just want to get you out of the rain.
Baby.
I'm going to come over here.
This is step up.
You grab that controller as well? Yeah. All right, appreciate you. We have a bouquet. Who has her bouquet? I need that.
Sorry.
I'm gonna take one picture of them over here.
I'm sorry.
I get a picture of this too. get the rest of them in this light.
Mom, can you tell them to get the shadow box, the sandbox? No, they'll do it. Have somebody from the venue get it, because it's a table.
So happy. So anyway, okay, we're ready? Okay.
Minutes.
Spin.
This picture is not a good one.
finger to here. I have to turn.